Cancel culture hit off in 2020 and 2021. Kevin Spacey was one of the first mainstream celebrities to go through it when he was accused of sexual assault by Anthony Rapp. Because of this, he was immediately taken off of House of Cards, but now he's starring in a new movie, The Man Who Drew God. So was he really cancelled at all? Why is it that being cancelled affects some people and not others? Is it even possible to be completely cancelled? With Kevin Spacey, whether or not he was cancelled was sort of up to producers on whether he would be offered more roles. But this is not the case when it comes to content creators. David Dobrik, for example. Over the course of 2021, various friends and colleagues of his came forward with allegations of sexual misconduct and bullying against him and his squad. Like a lot of YouTubers did when they got cancelled, he released an apology video and then continued posting like nothing had happened. He lost around 300,000 subscribers at the time, but 2 months later he stopped losing subscribers and now his videos are getting around 10 million views each, which is a significant drop off from the amount of viewers he was getting, but it's still significant in itself, enough to make a good living. This is a similar scenario as to what happened with a lot of other YouTubers like James Charles, Gus Johnson, and Shane Dawson, who all got cancelled for various reasons. They all released an apology video, they lost subscribers at the time, but then afterwards their views balanced back out. It seems as though if you can withstand the outside pressure and just be steadfast in what you create and upload, a portion of your viewership will continue to watch you. It's when creators can't withstand or don't want to withstand outside noise that cancellation is more effective. Jenna Marbles is one who seems to get the most "I miss her" tweets and comments. But she left the platform entirely after apologising for some mildly offensive jokes she made a decade ago after people started commenting on them. She, I would say, is one of the few successful cancellations because she completely left the space and hasn't been back. Fed Meister is a Twitch streamer who also left the space entirely after accusations of unwanted sexual advances. He tried to continue on as if nothing had happened, but then disappeared, seemingly like he couldn't take the heat. Cancellation can also have a completely opposite effect. There are a couple of examples of all press is good press with PewDiePie and Logan Paul. Both of their incidents, PewDiePie's casual anti-Semitic and racist jokes and Logan Paul uploading footage of a suicide victim, gained so much media attention that it only really led to more eyes on them. PewDiePie's channel grew from 57 million subscribers to 111 million, with all his videos getting millions of views, and Logan Paul is thriving in wrestling and has released a drink brand. They both seem to have only grown bigger. So the way I see it is that the only way to truly get cancelled is to have your platform removed entirely. If you're a YouTuber or a Twitch streamer, then that's to be kicked off of YouTube or Twitch entirely. If you're an actor, it's to never be offered another role. Gideon, for example, was a Twitch streamer who was removed from Twitch entirely for hate raiding another streamer, but he was also able to continue uploading to YouTube. Getting cancelled is really about how good you are at taking heat. There will be a lot of outside noise, and if you can handle that and stick through it, there'll be a percentage of your viewership who will continue to watch you afterwards. It seems that as long as these cancelled people are able to continue to create content, there'll always be people watching. But the thing these creators do need to live with is the knowledge that no matter what they do afterwards, there will always be a percentage of people who will view them as the person who did the bad thing.